If Amazon ads have been confusing at any point, this video is going to solve all of that. I'm going to show you exactly how you can use ChatGPT to analyze your ad data, help you turn off certain keywords, tell you what keywords you need to scale and increase bids on, for example, and all of that's coming up in this video. Let's go. Hey everybody, I'm Emeka and this is the Publishing Academy YouTube channel where we do one thing and one thing only, show you how to make more profits with your publishing business. So this video is one I'm really excited for. I've done a lot of ad videos on the channel before. They are my favorite videos to make because I love everything about running KDP ads, but this is going to be different. Oh, I wanted to do this for a very, very, very long time. And I'm just gonna give it to you all for free here on the channel because, well, you know, brokies can't pay me. And I need you to make more money with your Amazon ads so you can increase your profits, so you can work with me, so I can help you increase your profits exponentially. That is it. So let me show you what I've created with the help of a custom GPT that I've built that's going to become your Amazon ads doctor. I'm excited for this, okay? Let's do it. So what I've built is this custom GPT that you will have access to completely for free. And what it's gonna do is it's going to basically walk you through how I would analyze your ads if we were on a call together. And it's going to ask you for certain info and I'm gonna walk you through it in a second. You're gonna give you the info, it's gonna analyze it, it's gonna explain it to you, and then you're gonna be able to go and make those changes based on what it says. I do wanna put a disclaimer out there, right? Like AI, chat, me, we're not perfect. Right, it might make mistakes from time to time. I don't know, but I've been testing it and trying to like stump it. And so far, like 9 times out of 10, its suggestions are pretty much right aligned with what I would do for that ad scenario. So like it's pretty good, right? But just don't take it as gospel, so to speak, right? So how the system's gonna work is we're gonna give it screenshots, 3 screenshot system. And it's basically gonna analyze the screenshot and then ask you follow-up questions, and you're gonna keep giving it a total of 3 screenshots, and then you'll have the output of what you should be doing with your current ad campaign. So less talking, more show me, Emeka. All right, so first thing, to access this ads doctor, what you're gonna do is you're gonna click on the link that's in the description or the pinned comment. You're going to join my free Publish and Profit Challenge. Then you're gonna get an email. That email is gonna have your SKOOL link. The SKOOL link, you are simply going to join the SKOOL link. Okay, this is our SKOOL community with a couple thousand members. You're gonna join there. Here, somebody else is pending. Let's go ahead and add them right now. Yes, okay. So you're gonna join, you're gonna go to the classroom. Okay, this is where we keep all of our videos and stuff like that. So then you're gonna click on this, the KDP Ads Doctor, and then you're gonna click on the custom GPT, and it's gonna open up the custom GPT for you. Now, you can type whatever you want. You can say, let's get started. Okay, and you'll see what it's gonna say. Perfect, we'll do this by the book. Okay, I'm in KDP Ads Doctor mode now. Before I'm allowed to diagnose or recommend anything, we must do a mandatory 3 screenshot flow defined in the SOP that you uploaded. Okay, so step one is the screenshot number one. So the very, very first thing I do when I'm looking at my ads is I do a broad account overview. I wanna see what's going on day to, or like what's going on with the entire ads account. So that's gonna be the first thing. Now, you gotta send these screenshots in a specific way with specific data. So here I am in my ads dashboard, and you want to send the last 30 days so it has enough data to understand. So what you're gonna do, I'm on a Mac, right? So I just do, right, Command-Shift-4, I believe. And I'm going to send this entire screenshot in. Now, notice what I'm including. I'm including the date range of what I'm sending in. That's key. I'm including all of the names of the categories or names of the campaigns, the daily budget, impressions, clicks, spend, cost per click, orders, sales, and ACOS. That is the vital information that has to be included for this to work. So if you don't, I'll assume some of you don't know how to set up your columns. These are columns here, okay? If you don't know how to get these, what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to columns and you're gonna go to customize. This is gonna pop up. Then you're just gonna have like, you can have country, yes or no, status, yes or no, it doesn't matter. But what you want is start date, budget, impressions, clicks, spend, cost per click, orders, sales, and advertising, or cost of advertising, cost of sales, ACOS, right? You hit apply and then you're good to go. And then that's gonna give you all that data. This is the most important data. It's the most relevant data. It's what you need to see when you're analyzing your ads. Nothing else really matters at this point. So I'm gonna take that screenshot and I'm going to give it to the GPT here. And you can read this. I'm not gonna read all of this right now because you can read it when you go through it. So we'll add it in and then watch what's gonna happen. Okay, I'm locking up the account level diagnosis only. So right now, no optimization. We're just top level account. Like, here's what happened in my ad account in the last 30 days, right? It needs to understand what's going on the top level first, okay? So what I can conclude from screenshot one is you spent $15,000, your sales were $58,000, your ACOS is 26%, orders 3,700. This is a working profitable account, not a broken one. Off to a good start. This means we are optimizing for efficiency and scale, not stop the bleeding. Some of you are gonna be like, it's gonna say you're almost dead, right? So it's gonna give you different advice based on this first screenshot that you're providing, okay? And it says most mistakes here would come from over-optimizing, not underspending. Okay. Then strong performers. So it's gonna break down what it recognized. Strong performers, borderline watch list, right? Budget signals, right? Many campaigns are capped at $150 to $200 a day. Some campaigns are spend constraint, others not. This tells me scaling should be surgical, not blanket budget increases. There are probably winners buried inside mixed targets, right? So this is absolutely key. What I cannot conclude yet, this is critical, right? Which keyword ASINs are causing a high ACOS? You cannot tell that from the top level. And that's where so many people get this wrong. Okay, they turn off the whole campaign because they see it's at 200% ACOS and they just turn off the whole campaign thinking it's not working. That's the worst possible thing you can do. Okay, whether poor campaigns are failing due to bad targeting or bad search terms poisoning good targets. Another vital mistake that people make. So what we're gonna do is we're going to paste mandatory screenshot two, right? I've made this so it does not work if you don't feed it the data in the order that I'm showing you in this video, because this is just how you get good at ads, doing it like this. Right, I choose this, so it's gonna recommend what campaign to look at for inspection. And it's choosing calming, ASIN, exact, 39 break even, right? So why this one, and then it tells you, okay? Then in case you don't know how to do this, right? It's gonna tell you how to do it. You get a campaign, ad group, targeting, right? So we go, so I'm in the campaign, I'm in my ad group, and I'm on the targeting thing here, okay? So this is for a coloring book, okay? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a screenshot of this now, okay? Once again, I'm taking everything that I can here, including the date range, so it knows what I'm doing. Oh, you know what I should do? I should actually go all the way up to the top so I can give it all of that info up there as well. So it just knows that I'm giving it the right information for the right campaign and not accidentally giving it the other, like giving it a different campaign. Because I bet if you did, it would tell you. So I'm just gonna take the screenshot over, okay? And I'm just gonna go ahead and all I'm gonna do is hit enter. Okay, and then I'm gonna have a sip of my coffee. So now we've gone from the campaign level diagnosis down to the target level diagnosis. So we're stepped out, okay? Now, it's confirming we're doing the same time frame, right? Because if I looked at 7 days now, and I started at 30, but now I'm showing it 7 days, the data is gonna be all wrong, and it's gonna give you wrong information, and you screw up all your ads. So what I can conclude from this screenshot is the campaign is not broken. Total ACOS is around 21%, orders are 562, conversion is one sale per 10.6 clicks, very healthy, okay? This campaign deserves protection. Optimization should be surgical extraction, not pruning, right? Some of you guys just want to clear cut the entire forest when you should be only removing the dead trees. So target classification, right? Now I'm classifying targets without acting yet, right? Clean, scalable, right? So it's telling me, okay, this cozy girl Christmas is this is a core engine. So orders, 498 orders from this one campaign or from this one target in the last 30 days. So this is obviously, that one's printing money. Perfect. So early low risk, ASINs with less than 30 clicks, small spend, mixture, no conversions, right? Examples, advent calendar, volume, old fashioned, low click count. These are not eligible for negation or pausing yet. Why? Because they probably just don't have enough data yet. Contaminated, probably not confirmed. So it's even telling you it doesn't know everything yet. It needs more info still. These look bad, but maybe poisoned by search terms. The second biggest mistake publishers make with ads is if they don't just turn off a campaign because they see it's like a super high ACOS, they look down at their targets and then they see their targets. Okay, what's a target, Emeka? This is a target. And they see, hey, that target, like right here, this target for this book is 103% ACOS. Now, a lot of you would just go ahead and turn that off right away. That's a bad move. Because if we go look at another level below this, we can see that, oh, hey, you know what? Yes, this one ASIN ML3 got 44 clicks, but you know what? Maybe 40 of those clicks came from one specific search term that a customer was entering. So if we just block out that one search term, then all of a sudden this is an extremely profitable target. That's what we're gonna show next. So what I can't conclude yet is I cannot tell which search terms caused the spend on these ASINs. Whether those ASINs are mismatched or they're fine and triggered by bad keywords, like what I just talked about. What to paste next? It's screenshot number 3. And only then we know we can unlock action to take, right? So far it's told you nothing. It's just, it's gathering all the intel before it's gonna go storm the beaches or whatever, right? We have to gather the intel and figure out what's the game plan first. So now we're gonna go to search terms, right? We go to search terms, last 30 days, I'm gonna do the same type of screenshot, super big screenshot, so I can gather all the information here, right? One thing I wasn't doing is I wasn't sorting by spend. I could sort by spend just to ensure that we're dealing with the high spend ones first. You could really do spend or clicks, but whichever one you do, make sure it's the same one for every single screenshot. Okay, so I have spend sorted and all right, cool. Oh, and you know what else I need to do? I need to make sure my ACOS is showing. I could probably shrink this a little bit. I wonder, okay, let me go look. Okay, so at this point, honestly, I don't need costs per click at this point. Click-through rate, it's not super, super important. Impressions would matter. So just cleaning that up so we have a bit more information here that's more visible. Now, super big screenshot, okay? And then I'm going to go ahead and dump this screenshot in here, and it's gonna tell me what to do. Perfect, now we have the 3 required screenshots, so I'm allowed to act. Okay, I'll strictly follow the SOP flow and give you controlled permission-based actions only. Okay. Screenshot 3, search term diagnosis, right? And this range is good for, not good for judging yesterday's volatility, not relevant here. Okay, what I can conclude with certainty, the campaign is working because of keyword intent, not just ASINs. There is an ASIN exact campaign. Amazon's clearly matching keyword driven search terms behind the scenes. This confirms contamination before failure was the correct assumption. Okay, I'm classifying terms into promote, keep testing, block, using the SOP thresholds. Okay, promote, right? So it talks about promote these, okay? Now, what does promote mean? Promote means take it to a scaling campaign, right? These are keywords or search terms that you can use in a solo scaling campaign, a targeted scaling campaign, whether it's one target or whether it's like a targeting campaign with like 10 scaling keywords or search terms in there. Your choice. Keep testing. Do nothing yet, okay? A large part of ads is just doing nothing and letting time go, right? And that can be very hard when you're, you know, seeing stuff or when you're new, because you want to just play with things. The more you play with stuff, the more broken things become with your ads dashboard, okay? Block. So then it found a couple that do not work, right? Creative Haven Christmas Gnomes. 67 clicks, one order. Yeah, like we're not converting on that. We're going to go ahead and find that book and block it. Christmas Bold and Easy. We're just going to go ahead and block that specific book because they're not converting. Okay. Okay. What I cannot conclude and won't guess, because we don't guess when we're running ads. We just run it off data because that's the only thing that matters. And then, like, I'm not going to go through all of this right now because it'll obviously be changing as, you know, you're going to have different results and it's going to go in a different direction and stuff like that. But I want you to let me know in the comments what you guys think of this. And once again, it's totally free. Like, you just sign up to the Publishing Profit Challenge, go to the school group, go to the classroom right here, look for KDP Ads Doctor, click Custom GPT, you're good to go. Once you're inside the community though, of the Profit and Publish Challenge, like, you can ask questions about ads and stuff like that. So most authors I work with do not struggle with writing. They struggle with visibility. This sounds like a spammer. So, you know, yeah, you're 100% a spammer, right? And so what do? We just delete and bam, you'll end up stop watching my shit if you're watching this right now. We don't do spammers. So I hope, guys, this has been a wake-up call for all of you running ads. I love ads. Not everybody loves ads like me. And so I wanted to find a way that how could I help people understand how I see ads? And with the help of AI and this, I really think this is going to be the way of doing it. So let me know in the comments. When you join the school group, please, like, post the results you got when you went through the KDP Ad Doctor, and like, let me know, how did it help? What did you learn from it that you weren't aware of before? The final things I'll say is just remember, the screenshots are key. You want to get the entire date, the date range, the whole picture of everything. Make sure you're including the name. And then once you're at the targeting and search terms, make sure you are sorting by either clicks, so I did clicks here, or spend on the targeting and search terms. So it's just getting all the information correctly. But I'm excited. I think you guys are gonna love this. Like, I've been playing around with it a lot the last couple days, and it's been like, oh, that's really cool. So anyways, until next time, everybody, I'm Emeka. Peace.